I low-key forgot what we were doing for a minute.
I tell you right quick before you start, but I was looking at some of the videos one time, and I blink a lot. So yeah, watch and pay attention to see how much I blink. It's a lot. So now I'm always self-conscious of how many times
you
I blink.
You gonna be like, dude.
Bro.
You lose staring contest. Huh?
Yes, definitely. I don't know what you say. It's action time or something, but I just start blinking like crazy.
That's funny. Well, y'all, we back. We didn't have a podcast last week, huh?
Nah, man. You wasn't here.
Yeah. I had to go out of town for a little bit, you know. But we are back on track with the podcast. We are here with another new episode, new banger, new stuff to talk about, old stuff to recap. New stuff to wonder about, and you know, we here. I am half of this duo that brings you the Kicking and Social Hour podcast. I am Dr. Greg Grovey. Follow me on Instagram at Dr.Greg.Grovey.
He went from half of this amazing podcast to just half of this duo.
We still amazing.
I'm the other half of this amazing podcast. KJ, follow me on socials at Cool Ass K, and that is Cool with a K.
Cool with a K.
What's up, Doc?
Man, you know, not a lot. Happy to be here, you know.
These violent gunshots.
God is good, you know. First, want to give all thanks and honor to God, you know, who's the salvation, light of my life.
Let him use you.
Nah, but man, so you know, we normally do on foot about this time. Let the people know what you got.
I'm blinking a lot. I really, really love these shoes. I was supposed to have a second pair of George flaked on me, Jorge. I have on cool gray Jordan 4. He flaked on me, bro. Tough. He was like, I saw the price of what they were going for and I couldn't do it.
Did you add them on Facebook?
You think I should? I should expose them. Nah. I'm finna expose them tonight. It's too late. Hey, y'all don't mess with this seller, man. He flakes. Yeah, but I got on cool gray Jordan 4. One of my favorites.
Yes, you got on? Sir. I got on some all black Air Forces, but they're a little special because they are the Ama Moniere friends and family colorway.
Ain't that many pairs of those either, huh?
Nah, it's not. They numbered. I think Dan's showing you right there. They numbered. I really like this shoe. I had it for a while and didn't want to wear it just because I didn't want to wear it. And once I, you know, broke their virginity on the streets, I can't stop wearing them.
I've seen them a few times.
Yeah, it's probably like my fourth time wearing them.
It's going to pay off in the long run when you want to put them on 12, 15 years from now. And you don't got to worry about that bubble crushing.
Right.
So it's all good.
They almost going to make their way to the buy the door shoes. You know it go down. You can buy the door shoes.
That's one you just can't replace.
That's true. I like these shoes, though. Shout out to the Whitaker Group for making a great shoe.
I have my nails done.
I see you over there shining. That's baddest. Random.
I just want the shirt. Baddest. Don't touch me. I deserve the best. No
cheese.
If you can't afford
you,
to get
huh?
my nails done, leave me alone.
That's funny. It's always hard to come back to a podcast episode of freestyle because I feel like, you know, freestyles come with repetition. And when you miss a week off, it's a little difficult.
Yeah, I tried to practice the other day. You were there. It sucked. Greg was amazing, of course. Best freestyler in the world.
Right. It's the Dallas in me.
And
pause.
That's crazy.
Whoa. What did he say?
It's the city. It's because I was born and raised in Dallas, Texas. That's what's going on here.
You was original member of DSR, right? Oh, look at the old DSR cover. Greg was under. He went by. Can I say what you went by?
What?
Fat B.
I wish.
AKA Fat G. So on Apple Music, search Fat B and Tum Tum, and you'll hear some of Greg's greatest freestyles.
Yeah, and if you want to hear some of my R&B albums, search Teddy G. got some good bangers on there for you. But Dashiki Dan, let's see what we got this week.
Son, it's Dashiki Dan, the hype man.
Debo dead.
On the Kicking It Social Hour.
Who is that? Debo dead.
With him, I just don't be knowing if it's the beat
right.
or not.
I would say get you excited for the beat and okay. then change.
Debo then. We're not, you're not Dashiki then no more. Black History Month is over. We back to Debo then. Watch a chance.
Is this the beat?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
It's my bike, punk.
Episode 37. Yeah, we ain't playing. You want some of this too? Oh man, no, watch it Friday, dude. On my television. Gotta get money, gotta get a vision.
Well, hold on,
okay.
I'm a big fan.
Yep,
beat provided by Debo Dan. Watch a change and watch a bike. If you're running to Debo Dan, ain't nothing nice.
Yep, nothing nice. Might even evil. Man,
snuns like Evil Knievel. You sneaky. Just like a weasel. You thought I was done? No, I'm not. You're just looking nice. Give me a shot. Whoa, pause like a ball. Hold, pause again. Don't know what I'm saying, man. Shout out to Adan. Jealous where you at? Can we get 4? Maybe 8. And 8 more. That's a full 16.
Team.
Living the American dream.
Dream.
Me and Freaky G. We pull up on the scene.
Yeah, pulled up on the scene. Yeah, it's all good.
Okay.
Suck, never chew. Man, I'm watching the wood. Me and Keenan finna do nothing but black movie and TV show. What you got here?
Man, what do I got? Let me think a second. I gotta think of a movie plot.
Yeah.
Hold on. Is it a heart in this house tonight? 5 heartbeats, that ain't wrong. But I'ma hype it up like it did. It's my bike, punk. Watch it Friday again.
Yeah, he said the movie had to think of the plot.
Threw me on the spot.
Don't you say one word about a goddamn clock. Watching life. Talking about a stopwatch. I ain't even tripping. Yes, sir, playing hopscotch. When I was a little kid, that ain't what I did. I was on the playground trying to get slid.
Well, hold on, holla. If you got some flex, I like my bitch wet and squirmy. Watch it Friday after next.
Okay, yeah. man, Keenan, real smart like he went to class. I'm from Fresh Alpha Cops ass, watching House Party.
Well, we don't play. No more locked doors, watch it next Friday.
He like Friday.
I'm ready. I'm feeling up. I'm ready.
All right, bring it back, Dan. We got some more.
Oh, man.
Bro, out of all the movies, I can't think of no movie.
Right. I ain't gonna lie. Like, my mind. I was just thinking about what all they said on All 3 Friday. All
right. Okay, yeah.
Okay, I got him. I start off. You gotta be ready. When I start off, you gotta come back. Hey, Dan, what's good? Dope, let me out. Watching boys in the hood.
Do you care if you live or die? I don't know how I was gonna make that right.
Oh, man, that's crazy.
Okay, yeah, okay, but I'm back. Came back. Yes, it gotta be me. I had to get him. Watching Menace to Society.
Damn. Let me think. Let me take a sip of my drink.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm back.
Yeah.
I still ain't got nothing to say.
He back. Trunk crack. Get my brother's ball back.
Okay, I like to keep the toy. Damn, claw my jaw hurt watching on the baby boy.
Yeah. Yeah, playing games like I got a toy. Mama gotta have a life too, Jody. I'm watching baby.
Hold on.
I can't even think of no movies, bro.
Okay, I set them back. G, what's good? Do we have a problem? Watch the Minister of Society from Boys in the Hood. That ain't, wait, that wasn't what it was called.
Okay, yeah, but don't
watch drink my juice in the hood.
Yeah, okay,
damn,
yeah.
I messed up. I'm coming back.
I pick you up, give you a ride so you ain't got to walk. Did he hold you like this or like this? Watching money talk.
That was Friday.
No, it wasn't.
It was Friday.
That was Chris Tucker when he was in jail.
Wasn't that Friday when he grabbed Lisa? He was like, did he grab
no, me? I'm not talking about that when Chris Tucker was in jail with FaZe Un Love, and FaZe Un Love took off his shirt. That wasn't on Friday. That was money talk.
Okay. Well, I messed him up. He fresh from vacation. Ain't nobody here to see you, Otis. Watch the Temptations. Huh? Where you at?
Yeah. Okay. Kenan hit me. Like this shit sweet. Nights like this, watching the five heartbeats. Yeah. Keep going, playing, ain't no foul. Michael, come get this goddamn towel. Watching Jackson 5. Yes, I go live. Shucking, jiving, ain't no big jive. Watching Good Times, yes, sir, it's Dynamite.
Oh, we doing TV show.
Freestyling, man, I'm out of sight. Who stole my apple juice? That's barbershop, she had to get loose.
Okay.
That was Eve on my TV screen.
Yep.
Get your money back, man, mean. I don't even know what movie that was from. I think it was on Barbershop when he was like, I don't want the money. Take your money back.
Good. Yeah. What's good? I said that a last time, but what's good? I got enough money to buy 1,000 bars. What I'm watching?
Boys in the Hood.
Goddamn.
Yeah. Okay.
Same movie.
Yeah.
Like, I know that movie got a lot of lines.
It is. I'm gonna give you another. All
right, give me another.
Okay. Oh yeah. We at a party, but it ain't no sock hot. They got fish in the flow. Still watching Barbershop.
Okay. All right. No. Oh, nah, nah. Okay, we gotta do it.
Yeah, you can't.
You got a regular freestyle?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Damn, it's crazy.
Yeah. Who that? Who that trying to get down with our crew? It's kicking it in our favorite color blue. Kenan looked at me like, man, that ain't true, cause he liked the dang red. Yes, I'm going fed. I done came down fresh braids on my head, and I got a fresh lineup. That's a fresh edge. Ain't tripping, get sleepy, go to bed. What I said, trying to get some bread, trying to get some money. Ain't nothing funny. Shout out to my honey, that's Logan. Ain't even tripping, yes sir. Shout out Dan, playing the damn beats from the damn 90s.
Damn.
I ain't even tripping, yes sir. They can't find me. Like I'm playing hide and seek with my damn kids. It was sunny outside, so I went and got a lid.
Hey, talking about them old grad players trying to talk about some kicks.
Yeah.
I don't know you boys. You better tell me who you with.
Yeah.
If you went, we're kicking the squad. You better watch out, cause we coming real hard and we come to scream and shout. Ain't no talking, only throwing blows, throwing real hands. Greg with the right left uppercutted lens on your head. Did you hear what I said? I don't know, I forgot. Color, where you at? You sitting, come get up on the mouse. Talking about the freestyle. It's your turn. Dan Usher, Let It Burn needs to be the next beat. Greg coming with heat.
Yeah.
We might just sing. We might catch the street.
Yeah, Color over there, yeah, he gotta come around. But we too broke. He only freestyle with Tizo Touchdown. That's them.
Hey, that's true. That's true. They don't even angle this with Tizo Touchdown in town. And that's all right. All right, man, I think we just
Color was on
like
all the official South by shows, man. He don't freestyle for free.
He sing background for Tizo.
Yeah, that's all we got right now, man.
Hey, yo, Dan the Man.
I don't
like
that one back.
That was a good one. I'm just going to freestyle. I don't even care about no topics. Give me another beat, Dan. Oh, he brought another beat for real.
What's this?
Dallas wants some. Come get some. Dallas, you
see him over there.
Yeah.
He over there itching.
Where you at?
Yeah. Okay. We running, hopping over hurdles. Like, dang, I can't even get my mind. Okay, let me start that over. I was
saying,
yeah.
To say.
Okay. Dang, I can't. My turn. running, hopping over haters like it was a hurdle. This Adidas is from the Ninja Turtle.
Man, we go hard, squeeze it tight like a girdle. I used to know this chick, her name was Myrtle.
Urkel, from Family Matters.
Did I do that? It don't matter. Go and get a wing platter. No chicken tingers.
Chicken tingers?
Chicken. Damn, I don't even know what I was trying to say.
Chicken
but I'm still freestyling. Every damn day I'm going hard. I pull your card. Shout out to G, that's my boy.
Trying to get some money, yes sir, save a rack.
Yep.
Why this Jordan ain't got 23 on the back?
Damn, I did see that going kind of viral. Why don't?
I don't know.
All right.
Well, still a good shoe, come and pick this joint up. It come out next Saturday for a couple of bucks. Maybe 190, maybe 220. Come get in line, yes sir, we got plenty. 1, 2, 3, 4, you can get many. Ain't talking about the mouse in the house. I like shirts, games, blouse. That's what they said on Dave Chappelle.
Versus Prince. On the show. Freestyle. We let you know, never written, so don't mistake it. Put it in the oven, cook it, watch me bake it.
Watch you bake it, but I might fry it. Raven didn't like her hair, so she had to dye it. Now it's a new color. Shout out to my mother. Shout out to Keenan, he like my damn brother. I like pork chops, yes sir, I like them smothered.
Yep.
Under some rice, yes she was nice. I ain't even tripping, yes
sir. On my neck, I got the ice. I don't even never give a damn about the price.
What they hitting for? I'm talking about the dice.
In your hair, I think you've got some lice.
I don't, cause I am black. Oops, my bad, did I say that? But that's what
in my
they told
pocket,
us.
I got a bunch of stacks.
Yeah.
We used to move the packs. Talking about them shoes. Greg, what it do? Not one, not two.
Not three, not four, maybe even five. Yes, sir, the freestyle is live.
You a turkey, child. Surprise.
Keenan trying to take a dive. Mean he try. Oh, yeah. Okay. Big Kylo, the step in the dough. He got some lines and he wanna give some more.
Yeah.
He from the third ward of the Houston, Texas. He coming down and you know he in the Lexus.
Yeah.
Don't got no plexus.
What's his name? Colin Teagle. Soaring like an eagle. And the truth like Beanie Siegel.
Yeah. Barking like a beagle.
Man! Colin, where you at? We trying to get these boys. Keep it a stack on the mic.
Oh, yeah.
He said he ain't coming. Psych.
Come on, Colin, with your outfit on. Hey, you seen that movie, Who Cloned Tyrone? It was good. Shout out Jamie Foxx. Ain't tripping, yes, sir. I got a box that I hide all my expensive stuff.
That's a safe. It's called a safe.
Some might call it a safe.
Colin been dressing like district manager of the year, boy. My boy ain't put on a pair of sweats. Not no dingy tees. Not no old shoe, no running shoe, no holy socks.
For the last 28 days, Colin been dressing like he got interviews at shoe stores.
Like he got to travel the world and do them. Colin, where you at, man? What's up?
Like he got Excel reports to file.
Dan, stop. We got to talk about something.
We talking about Colin.
Colin ain't playing no games.
Nah, I'm done talking about
We got to talk about something, Dan.
He got dressed like he just updated his resume.
Like he finna take a LinkedIn picture. Oh, man. He like he have a thumbs up in his LinkedIn picture, too.
Colin dressed like he got AI-generated pictures on his Indeed profile.
In real life. He walking around a real life AI-generated picture.
Oh, Colin, you wanna come freestyle? Yeah. Oh, man.
Colin, man, come on.
Of course you do,
that's it.
Who do y'all think is the best dress in the store?
Oh, that's me, easy. It's crazy. You asked him some crazy questions.
You didn't even let me finish
this. When I put that shit on. Nah, I'm gonna have to give it to my boy B. Diddy does it.
B Diddy does do it.
Shout out to B Diddy does it.
Hey, shout out VD, man. My boy finna graduate his barber license in a few days. Well, by the time this come on, he'll be done. Shout out VD handling that business right there. All right, man.
So let me give you a breakdown. Me at number one. Got to. Who else work here? I don't even work.
Nobody else even matter.
All right, I'm going to go with my brother G. I'm going to give a second to I'm going to give it to you, Lil Ray Ray. Be putting on sometimes. Sometimes I'll be like, what the fuck? Like, what's going on? But most of the time I'll be like, all right, I get it. I get the vision.
But all that was unnecessary.
All right, that's cool. Second. Third, I'm going to give you third. I'm about to come back here a second and give it to my boy Colin. Colin been going crazy, man.
Colin,
come here. Please.
That's good, please. That's good.
No, I don't need you to watch that. Come on.
Look at my boy.
Yeah! They're doing a round one. Polo, man, come on, man. Raven, I give you third. That's all I'm going to stop.
I'm going to put a poll up on IG.
I'm going to. I never lost a poll on kicking the IG. You realize that, right? Me first, though, above all.
See, I got an unfair advantage, though. I got to shop in the big and tall section, so it's harder for me to find stuff.
Y'all didn't know. Louis made big and tall. Let's go.
They do not. So Kenan is lying.
You
going
to say top three since he really only
made
three?
Oh, man, I think everybody do their own thing. You know what I'm saying?
No.
I don't judge. It's not for me to judge.
He being politically correct. I'll tell you where I fit suck, though.
Nah,
I like I like everybody's style. Everybody got their own style. Everybody do their own thing. My boy Dallas hits you with the fitness wear, Lululemon type shit. You know what I'm saying? You know, my boy George, he gonna hit you with a little bit of Supreme oversized fit. You know, he do his thing. Sierra, she gonna roll the shirt up on one side. When she roll that shirt up on one side, she don't mean she ain't playing no games. You know what I'm saying? And, you know.
And V Diddy constantly do it.
V Diddy always does it. Oh. What just happened? Did that mean like we... But you was doing some weird... Like, what happened?
Nothing.
We still good to go?
Keep going. Bro, we like 30 minutes in. I ain't talked about nothing.
Yeah, they gonna cut this one off. But that's all right. If you still here, we finna talk about something right now.
Yes, sir. You know, we had a lot of freestyles, y'all. It probably ain't it. You know, if y'all don't like them, just fast forward them. Yeah, you know we got more. You gonna fast forward right into another one. Man, this was a good time in my life, man.
Never gonna watch this. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's a Midwest swing. Watch me do my thing. Had a long chain, used to slang down and bang. Like it was a blood, maybe even a crib. I ain't even tripping, put Carmex on my lip. So it won't be ashy, so it won't be dry. 23 years and yes, I've been fly. Really 37, yes, I'm getting old. I ain't even tripping, cause old is the gold, but the freestyle cold. Got a dang chain. I ain't even tripping, yes, sir, I'm the main. Got a dang rollie on my dang wrist. It's your boy Greg, and I rap like this, and I rap like that. My trunk crack.
Yeah.
I love black people, cause I'm black. I love everybody, cause I'm not racist.
All right. Do not play another beat.
So you might even want to cut that one off. Cut that whole ass verse off. Oh, man. No, but
Can we start now?
Yeah, speaking of great rappers such as myself, it was good to see, man, the homie Wale get his flowers for all the contributions that he gave to the sneaker community since the late 2000s, you know. He's been floating around on the internet, and someone even went as far to say that the Travis Scott sneaker collab really belonged to Wale. It should have been Wale. It should have been. So I don't think it should have been Wale. I mean, Travis Scott is an amazing partner. Yeah, he's an amazing artist. However,
Wale do deserve
Feel like Wale deserves a collaboration with the major brands. And when we say the major brands, y'all know what big boys we talking about. We talking about the Nikes and the Jordan brands and the Adidas. You know what I'm saying?
No, one more.
Wale has had some collabs. He did an ASICS collab with a WWF theme. I'm sorry, WWE theme. He had a few Timberlands. Has he done anything else besides ASICS and Tims?
You got the tweet, Colin.
Is Sneaker Fetish, and he says
Sneaker Fetish beef.
Wale was done terribly by the sneaker industry. He deserved more than being a collaborator with a collaborator under Villa/ASICS. I know people saw him as problematic, but we all know Wale is that guy with the kicks.
Yeah, I agree. So I like Wale as a rapper too. I think he's really underrated as a rapper. He definitely has some really hard punchlines and bars. But I agree, he definitely deserved to be more than a collaborator. He did a lot for the culture. First song I ever heard, what was the first Wale song you ever heard?
Oh my God, it's gonna bother me because I knew what it was. It was it had like some poppy stuff to it. It was.
A lot of his stuff had like kind of DC pop music.
DC chilling, PG.
Oh yeah.
What was? I can't remember nothing.
I think it was called Chilling.
Yeah, with Lady Gaga. Yeah, that was his first song, right?
I think that was his first major song. The first song I heard from Wale was Nike Boots though, and I only listened to it because it was a remix with Lil Wayne, and I was like, damn, this dude actually kind of hard though. Like, yeah, DC. Yeah, it's called Chilling, ain't it? Yeah. Yeah, I would love to see Nike or Jordan Brand reach out to Wale now and see what he can do. His hype definitely isn't as big as it used to be.
Yeah, I was about to say, is that actually going to even happen at this point?
Probably
it needs to happen, though. Like, for the culture, Wale is a big part of the culture. Like, in this era, our era, Wale is a big part of the culture. Especially, he was who he was, and, man, he wore everything. It wasn't like it was... like one sided, it wasn't one type of shoe. It was everything. It was Jordans, Nikes, foams, New Balance.
Yeah, I would say Wale was
ASICS.
Definitely the first person I saw like in a public eye rocking foams.
Everything. And that's why I think he's such an important part of the culture, bro. Like, it was a lot of people like, damn, bro, I want those. Like those 17s when he wore the 17s, which they was trying to say he brought the 17s back, which I really don't agree with. But that made people want those 17s at the time when he won my 106 apart.
Yeah. Classic LRG ad wearing eggplant phones. Man, and then he had that song where he started off that verse and he was like, pine green phones, they may never see the store. I was like, damn, bro. To be able to rap about shoes, like he really know what he's talking about. Paris SBs make these catch Caesars.
And that's the craziest part about all of it, though. It's not too many people or celebrities who in the game, bro, who call themselves sneakerheads that know what they talking about, especially from like just a vast amount of information. Like Wale knows pretty much everything. I would say he's one of them people that know, like us. Yeah. Like he really relatable.
Yeah, nah. Wale, come on the show. Clip that, Ray. Bam. Mm. What was your question?
So, obviously he's a staple in the sneaker collection, or excuse me, whatever.
Do community?
Y'all, there you go. Yep. Do y'all feel like the newer generation recognizes that, or is it just like millennials and
The newer generation so don't like recognize with, nobody but Travis Scott and Kanye.
Right.
So how would y'all think that like a legit Wale collab would do right now? Because I mean, we get 12-year-olds, 13-year-olds, 18, 20 plus whatever.
I think it'll bring out a certain era of people, a certain time period of people. I think it'll work regardless of the fact. If it was now or then, I think today it still would work.
Yeah, I think it'll probably sell out just because I think it'll probably be a dope shoe. Not necessarily because it's a Wale collaboration, but people who might not be familiar with who he is and what he did for the sneaker culture will probably see it and just be like, damn, it's a dope colorway. Like, I want this. And it's kind of like when Trinidad James dropped their first homework shoe.
That's what I was thinking too.
A lot of people didn't even realize it was a Trinidad shoe or cared, to be honest. You know, they were just like, oh, this is cool looking. See-through Saucony, like, you know, I think it'll be the same effect with Wale. We just got to be honest here. No shots at nobody, but Wale is definitely bigger than Trinidad James.
Yeah.
So if Trinidad James can get his own shoe, Wale definitely deserves his own shoe. And no shots at Trinidad.
Right. Wale Trinidad. Just deserved what he deserved. Like, you can't really take it away from what he means to the culture. And I don't know why people don't give him that respect, bro. Like,
but it's the same with rapping. We all remember that rant he called up to Complex and was like, how dare y'all not put me on that top 10 list or whatever.
And I think that's what it is, bro. I think you just don't know what you getting from Wale when you mention him, bro. Like,
yeah, but really, so from that perspective, Wale and Kanye is the same person. Like, I mean, I think obviously Kanye is bigger, so he may be a little more respected, but I think he's just passionate about what he does. He's passionate about
the products he produces.
Yeah, and he don't miss. I mean, it's a lot of, well, they've been going hard, Paul, since he first came out. Like, he don't really miss too many albums. Like, he don't miss on too many songs, but for some reason, they just never blow up like that. I don't know what the reason is.
He ain't got the machine.
I think he is independent
him,
now. But even when he was with MMG, like, I feel like they wasn't doing him justice then.
He had like Lotus Flower Bum, and he had a good run with MMG, but
yeah, he good for a single every time he drop a project.
Yeah. Like, Sue Me is gonna be one of my favorite songs forever. Man. Like, that's just a hard song.
It's like the all-time black playlist gone in all time. All
right, so I got a question for y'all. If Wale was able to come up with a collab with any brand and a shoe, what shoe and what brand would you choose?
I would like to see him work on a phone or a variation of a phone posit, maybe a flight posit, a Total Max foam, anything with foam posit.
I feel like he's so versatile. I would like to see it like a Goadon boot.
Yeah, I do feel like you wanted a debate on like who made Goldones popping, like him with Jim Jones.
No, sir, it's not a conversation to be had.
That's what they were saying.
Get out of here.
That's what they said, bro.
I get out of here. I don't want to talk about that.
So who you said? It's clearly who? Wale. Yeah, but
Nike boots. The song made everybody want Nike boots.
Hey, I agree. I'm just telling you what
think
the people
about it.
Said.
Let me be real. Like, y'all might have, but I didn't never see a Nike boot. Period. Until Wale had the song Nike Boots. And then I realized that there was a Nike boot.
Yeah.
Like, that's not one of them shoes us in the South, like, looked at. First off, we didn't really look at boots. And then the only boot anybody know here was Tim's. Mm-hmm. And so when Wale dropped Nike Boots, it was just like, damn, they got Nike Boots?
Right.
And they high too?
Yeah, Goldums did go crazy after that, though. To us, maybe they been popping up there.
But. Right. But for him to make a song, I mean, clearly. But if I had to choose a shoe for Wale to work on, it would either be a Dunk. A SB Dunk or a Jordan 17.
SB Dunk is hard, too.
Because he was up on Dunk. Man, he was up on a lot of stuff before people was on it.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. That's true. Wale is definitely one of the first people that I remember, like, continuously rocking SBs, too.
Dallas, what's up?
No, I was just going to say that.
I don't know if they can hear you.
Yeah, can't hear you.
I was just going to say that I feel like that 17 would be a good one since the 17 had been out for about 10, 11 years when he rocked it on 106 and Park. Mm-hmm. Essentially, he retroed it to introduce his new music.
He definitely introduced it to a crowd of a new era, a new crowd of people.
Yeah. Had Wale ever showed his collection?
Like in the Nike Talk days, it was pictures. But I don't.
But he ain't ever did like a.
Not to my knowledge.
Not like a vlog or anything like that.
I want to know if he still got it.
Come on the show, bro, or invite us to your wherever you keep your collection, man. Let us start the Kicking It Social Hour Closet Cast, and we just go through your closet. Yeah. But, yeah, man, shout out Wale. Come on the show, man. But it's amazing to see him get his flowers, even though it's probably like 24 years too late.
Are you not happy, or you're only half happy? Or
still to be happy about.
You're up too old.
Job's not finished. Job finish? I don't think so. Okay.
But, you know, better late than ever. Yeah. At least he can, like my boy Kanye say, people never get the flowers while they can still smell them. So if you admire somebody, you should go ahead and tell them. So it's glad he got his while he's still alive. Yeah, you like, damn, that's a bar. Kanye got them bars, boy. You know, you ain't got them bars, man. Yeah, I wish Kanye could do a residency in Vegas. That would be hard. Yeah. I'll be there multiple nights.
You the segue king, man. But
you see where I'm going?
Yeah, man. You cold, man. I ain't gonna lie. You might be a rapper.
Hey, yeah.
If Kanye did do a Vegas residency, though, I would be there.
For sure. You know, it'd be a hell of a show. But who else might do a few nights in Vegas is Bruno Mars. Because reportedly, he is 50 million dollars in debt to MGM.
Man, like giving me dope fiend vibes from the picture that Raven showed. Face a little sunken in.
Wasn't Bruno Mars who leg dropped that girl?
Nah, that was Miguel.
Miguel.
Yeah. Okay. That was Miguel with the WWE move. Yeah. That's stupid.
Yeah, man.
What's wrong with your boy, bro? Like, but the even messed up part about that is, why does MGM let him rack up a $50 million gambling debt in the first place?
I guess they figure he good for it.
Bro, so supposedly that's who he does his residency with, is with MGM. And they say after tax, he cleared like 1.5 per show.
1.5 million?
Yes.
Oh, he got a lot of shows to do.
So just a 50 show run and he good?
Not if you keep gambling.
I often say, yeah, he got to stop playing though. 50 shows, bro, that's a long time.
And he might be thinking about like, man, I ain't tripping about this. I'm gonna make a little bit of this tomorrow.
And then the IRS on your ass. Because
somebody at MGM gotta be like, hey, Bruno, stop.
Why would they do that?
You sound like Michael Jordan. If I had a problem, I wouldn't have my rings. I would have sold my rings. Come on, bro. It's not, he got a problem, bro.
He do. Allegedly, a high roller sat next to Bruno Mars and saw him lose $17 million in one setting.
At what point do you be like, hey?
Well, because you know, once you get to that level, you know, they give you a credit.
You got even line of credit.
Putting up money, like, you got a line of credit.
At what point do you be like, hey, stop? And I guess you don't if it's a multi-millionaire.
I'm sure them bets went up and up and up, too, chasing that money. I wonder what his game of choice is. Did he mention anything?
Bro, I'm not going to lie.
I didn't mention anything.
If I had a credit and I know they was going to let me keep crediting, and I'm 17, I'm 50 million in, I'm like, 50 million on black.
Hell nah.
50 million on black. Either I'm going to break even or I'm going to be 100 million in. And if I'm 100 million in, who cares? I was already 50 million in.
That's some hardball Keanu Reeves shit right there, boy.
That joint finna be green.
Man, if I hit 100 mil, I'm going to say, hey, 100 mil on red. But that's what I do.
Double zero.
God. Oh, dude, what's the movie when he... I told you not to let this kid in.
All the nights.
Told you not to let this kid in watching Harlem Nights. Man, I'm out of sight. Man, I got thirsty, so
don't
I popped
it,
open
Dad.
A Sprite. I could do this all night. It's all right. No, I'm just playing.
That's kind of like when you racked up like that meal or two in Vegas, bro. Luckily, you got it all back, man.
Bruno Mars a wild boy. wild boy, man. I'll be interested to watch Bruno Mars play some blackjack.
Bro, like, clearly he can't play. What are we watching him for?
A lot of doubling down going on around there, man. The question poses...
He should go catch a grenade for somebody, because... Exactly. He's not finna get this money back.
As someone who enjoys a hand or few, not two.
He essentially a slave.
Colin shoots shots, a hand or few. Can you ever see yourself down this? Absolutely not.
Down $500, bro. I've been down one time like 7 or 8 with G when I was just like, hey, look, it was 6, matter of fact, because I had 6 left. So I'm put it on black. But I'm black, I got my money, I broke even, I went to bed. You want to go gamble? I'm going to sit right next to you. I don't want no parts of this.
Bro, it's crazy because, I mean, we can't see ourselves losing $17 million because we don't have $17 million.
Got it, then.
But, you know, if you transition that down to our level, it's like, can you see yourself losing $17? I could. But if he's only clearing 1.5 a show... That's tough to be $50 million in debt.
He's basically a slave, bro, at this point.
Yeah, instead of washing dishes, he doing residency shows.
Which is nuts. He got to stop. Somebody, where his friends at?
That's a good question. I wish I knew more Bruno Mars song titles and I would have had some puns here, but I don't really know any of his songs like that.
Yeah, is gambling and debt, is gambling debt is a runaway baby?
Is that one of his songs?
You clearly heard of Bruno Mars' album that we didn't hear.
Right.
Subsonic? Y'all listen to Subsonic?
No.
I gave it a once what, over.
He don't got no 24 karat magic in the casinos. No. Yeah.
You think, dang, that's funny. He took about the one song I know. I was going to say if he plays roulette, I wonder if he bets on 24 karat magic.
Got him. Shut up, man. Oh, man. Nah, but man, thoughts and prayers for Bruno, man. I hope.
Nah, I'm not praying for Bruno over no gambling debt. I got much more important things to pray about than a millionaire.
Pray for Michael.
And 50 million. Michael?
Yeah, Jordan.
I wasn't praying for Michael Jordan debt either.
I'm praying for him to be locked out in Epic. That's a Bruno Mars song.
All right, you don't want to listen to Bruno Mars, bro. There you go.
Clearly, he's the only one. That might be why he's in debt, because nobody's listening to his songs besides Dan. Crazy. Tell you what songs I am listening to. Carnival. Cue Carnival, Dan. Go, 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 go. That's the new shit on the road. She ride the black carnival. I don't need the impossible. Go, 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 go. That's the new shit on the road. She ride the Carnival, I don't need the impossible. Yep. So Ye and Ty Dolla Sign sat down with Big Boy. During the interview, Ye said he's invented every style of music over the last 20 years. He invented every style of music over the last 20 years.
Nuts.
Say that he's had a hand.
He proved my point every week.
So, Dan, let's go to work real quick. Got some stuff I want you to play so we can prove Kanye's point here.
Kanye is nuts, bro.
I don't think he's that nuts.
Yes, he is. If he said, like, certain people, then I'll be like, all right, Travis Scott and all them, yeah, cool. But when you go to, Thugger or some of them other people, Gunna, that come from Wayne, bro. You got to give Wayne some of the credit for some of the advancements in hip-hop, too. It's not just Kanye over the last 20 years.
Last 20
years.
Him.
You got Jay, you got Kanye, you got Wayne, you got probably a few other people in there. Not too many, but...
Yeah, and this is a real question because I don't really listen to Young Thug, but you don't think Young Thug was influenced by Kanye?
No, sir. Not at all.
No, strictly, I don't know. I don't Wayne. Listen to Young Thug. Well, Drake, Future, Travis Scott, for sure. I don't know, man. Like, the people he said, the music genres, he did explore a lot of genres and make people record music differently.
Especially when you got to 808s and Heartbreaks, then you got a lot of 808s in the music after that. And so I do think he played a pivotal role in music, but every genre in the last 20 years is... nuts, bro. That's insane.
Yeah, not every, but a lot. He had a hand in a lot. Nah, country been there. You know, I guess. Nah, he ain't ever did.
God,
Beyonce is. She just announced that she's dropping her new
Cowboy
country
Carter.
Cowboy Carter on the 29th.
I'm not excited for Cowboy Carter.
Why? Because this ain't Texas?
And I don't hold up.
He go down, down, down.
I actually like that song. I ain't gonna lie. I put that on the car. That's hard right there. But, we not even talking about Cowboy Carter.
We wasn't. But the queen has entered the room.
All right.
You talk about somebody who don't miss.
You don't think Beyonce missed? Renaissance was trash.
Overall.
I'm gonna get attacked for this.
I was finna say according to you, but according to these tour sales.
Yeah, but
that's what we but
can't
you're not
say
a,
who's there.
But you're not a
it wasn't us.
Beyonce fans. Bro. But you're not a Beyonce
bro,
fan.
Did you see
though.
The concert? Did you see who was there?
Beyonce fans.
Okay. I'm a Beyonce fan. I'm a Beyonce fan, but this album was made specifically with a certain fan in mind or shining light on certain types of fans. And those fans weren't me or us. And so I didn't like it. I thought it was trash.
But her
some of the songs.
Yeah, her hardcore.
I was in a movie and watching everything. So don't get me wrong. I like Beyonce. And I be Beyonce go crazy in the car when you by yourself. Especially that 1+1. That's me.
I saw a clip on Instagram.
Why are we talking about Beyonce?
I don't know, it's random. I saw a clip on Instagram that said every black male's favorite Beyonce song is Me, Myself, and I.
Nah.
And dudes do be singing that song pretty hard, though.
I might go hard through the 1+1 is crazy.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, but we were talking about Kanye making these genres of music. He definitely had a hand in them. But your boy Boosie Badass, entered the chat and says, wipe me down. Now, that's a banger.
I think Kanye mentioned Boosie first, though. I think, right? I don't know.
I don't think so.
Nah, but Kanye responded.
Yeah. I mean, you know, hit dog holler. He say, Boosie says, wipe me down, was not inspired by Kanye. And wipe me down is not a genre of music as well.
Bro, honestly, I kind of feel like in the South or in Louisiana that Boosie was like a pivotal point in music too.
And yeah, for sure.
I don't know where it came from. Maybe UGK or maybe Master P, Cash.
Well, yeah, he was signed to PMC then.
His sound was different from anything we had before that in the South. So I would say he had a pivotal point in music.
It was like almost like Louisiana boogie music. You right. know what I'm saying?
So, but Kanye responded and said he did not influence. What did he say?
I don't know. I think that's what Raven is showing. Read
nah,
it.
No, we can't see that.
So he said, I just saw that Wipe Me Down was made in 2007. I take no responsibility for whatever that genre would be called.
Oh. And then that sparked the conversation in our group chats where everybody was naming Boosie songs that the Wipe Me Down that was better than a lot of different Kanye West songs, which I really didn't agree. You pull that group set up, Colin. Let's see what some and tell us who said it. let's see. This moment of silence.
The Wipe Me Down.
Rap.
Rap. Would it be bounce? I want to hear bounce. I think
man.
About
you can't disrespect bounce and Big Frida.
Yeah, Big Frida. Yeah.
I know you had that. That one video you liked from Big Frida doing that thing.
Ian Swisher Stonebrook.
What?
Said,
he reading, bro.
Said, Wipe Me Down is better than Stronger.
All right. Yeah. And,
shout out to Boardroom Gabe. He said, Wipe Me Down is better than Never Let Me Down. And then Brett said.
That's insane, bro. Then Brett said, that's a really random song to pick. Like.
Brett said, Wipe Me Down is better than Gold Digger.
I might agree with
that. I don't say that.
And then Ian said, I'm going to go as far as to say Wipe Me Down is better than Can't Tell Me Nothing. And that's what Stark said, whoa, buddy.
Yeah, so some interesting conversation came from that topic. But you got a song that Wipe Me Down is better than the Kanye song? What you got?
A song that's better than Wipe Me Down?
No, what song from Kanye is not better than Wipe Me Down?
Drunken High Girls.
I'm gonna say
that song.
What's the song with
Workout Plan?
I'm gonna say Workout Plan.
What's the terrible? No, what? I like Workout Plan. It's top 10 Kanye songs.
It's not
for me.
Better than Wipe Me Down, bro.
Especially when he came through and put Mr. Bentley on the remix.
You think Farm Workout Work. Plan is better than Wipe Me Down?
Yeah.
Dan, cut his mic off.
But you know what it's not better than?
No more drinks for him.
Two words. Ain't that what it's called? Two words.
Yeah, two words most. Yeah.
Terrible song. I hate that song. And Breathe In, Breathe Out.
Breathe
Wipe
In.
Wipe Me Down is way better than Breathe In, Breathe Out.
Yeah, I agree.
Get this trash out of here.
You like Workout Plan better than two words?
Bro, Workout Plan. Damn, give me Workout Plan, man. Come on, man. You finna get these bars for disrespecting Workout. And then when he put Bentley on that joint. Now stop. Hey, Farnsworth came crazy on the remix. But you better hope it ain't.
It is, cause he been talking about it.
New Workout Plan.
Oh yeah, he would have been talking about that.
And two and three and four and get them sit up right and set them tummy
tight. You said Wipe Me Down better than this?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yep.
stop, breathe,
get up, check your weed.
Don't disrespect.
It's a good song, but
pick up the blunt, disrespect it. It's a party tonight, and Boosie so excited. Come on, bro.
Tell me who's invited. You, your friend, and mine.
What's crazy to me?
Hey, girls look like Halle Berry to me.
So excuse me, miss, I forgot your name. Good night,
Come on, man. Yeah, but did he already play Wipe Me Down?
In the verses, this wipe and wipe me down. In the verses.
B-O-O-S-I-E.
W-E-B. W-E-B-B-Y. Get this out of here, man.
Yeah.
After workout plan, you got this over workout plan.
Yeah. Yeah.
You got this over workout plan?
I'm with Boosie, lead the line.
Bro, this is like
B-E-N-T-L-E-Y. You don't know, you better ask somebody. Come on, bro. Y'all don't got that up.
Bro, this girl looks like I don't eat, but I don't drink
on me. They said this the current Negro spiritual place.
Bro.
Where you gotta just keep going.
I like this man like Rick Ross. Gotta hit, I said it out when I see it.
Everybody said it out.
Nah.
Your neighbor.
That boy said, wait a minute.
I love it, don't, man.
See, cause it Wipe Me Down is more of an inspirational song than anything. It lets you know tough times.
And workout plan didn't inspire you to work out?
For sure not. Not the workout he's talking about.
It inspired me.
Give it, stop, breathe. Get up, check your weed.
You can't say that.
Oh, good.
And the best part, a lot of ladies.
The best part of workout plan is roll the plane.
Nah, not the
Boosie out here inspiring. That boy say gas ain't gonna eat, but you know what? I ain't tripping. All drinks on me.
Yeah, he was tripping.
He ain't tripping.
This nigga said in the car like, damn.
I could get some gas, but I'd rather buy everybody a drink to turn them up. But
that ain't even Boosie's song, bro.
That's his song. So, Ray,
the Fox,
Lil
man.
Ray, I think this needs to be a poll. Wipe Me Down or Can't Tell Me Nothing? Because that's where we stopped at. We not going to even say Wipe Me Down versus Workout Plan. That's not
that's
even.
That's not fair.
That's not.
That's not fair in Texas.
Not fair.
You can just add.
Right.
You can just add. All right. Create all
this. Nah, people gonna say no, but I'm interested to see if people think Wipe Me Down is better than Can't Tell Me Nothing. What do you think the best Kanye West song of all time is? Okay, I say one of the best. He has so many good songs. It's hard to say the best.
Man, can I look?
Let's get a round table.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to sit here, everybody. I'll go first.
Yeah.
Damn.
Of course you will.
Kind
of
got to start with what blew him up. Through the Wire is an amazing song.
No. It's not even top five.
How you going to tell me my favorite song?
It's not top five.
Can't Stop Me From Rapping, help. Why can you got all these instrumentals?
It's not top five.
Nah, it's not. This. You think it's top five?
Ooh. For sure.
I say,
the one where he actually did it through the Wire.
Yeah, that's how you gotta hear the pain and hurt in this man's voice.
This is what turned me on. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, but then it ain't after the Vast collection, all the albums. I from this album, I would say We Don't Care is even better than Through the Wire.
Ah, man,
it's so inspirational.
Somebody come take Keenan.
If this is your first time hearing
so
this, you are about to experience something so cold. We never had nothing handed, took nothing from granted, took nothing from no man. Man, I'm my own man. And as a shorty, I looked up to the dope man. Only a dope man, I knew that wasn't bro. Hey, man, I used to look up to the dope man. That's only a dope man, I knew that wasn't broke, man. Man, you don't know, man. Damn. What's wrong with you? You ain't feel no inspiration from that when that came on? We Don't Care.
I didn't say I didn't. However,
but did you feel inspired? I feel inspired right now.
You don't feel inspired through the Wire when he's rapping with his mouth wired shut?
I agree. It was a very dope song, bro. But Through the Wire was Kanye's whole signature sound from the initial step.
That's
because
that's the first
like,
song y'all heard.
It
wasn't even Kanye's first. That was his first single from that album. He had songs before that sounded just like that.
Keenan, you're not telling us anything new, fam. We said our favorite song.
You remember the College Dropout mixtape, right? That didn't have that song on it. That had every other song from the album on it.
But Keenan, we talking about our favorite
y'all
songs.
Y'all ain't
why.
Talking to y'all. Y'all ain't too Kanye fan. That song was trash.
He's
It ain't trash. I'll take that back. Hold on. Calm down.
Okay. I was finna say, come on now. Oh, my God.
I got a little passionate on my Wale shit, but nah, bro. Through the wire, not the one, bro.
He drinks a Boost for breakfast?
An insert for dessert.
Somebody order pancakes. I just sipped the scissor.
Come on.
That right there can drive a sane man bizzard. Man, come on, man. Not to worry.
She's gonna say some bullshit. All right, no, let's hear it.
How do I console my mom?
I give her light support.
Telling her son's on life support?
And just imagine how my girl feel.
On a plane scared as hell that a guy look like Emmett Till.
That was so dramatic. She was with me before the deal. She been trying to be mine.
She's a Delta. Ooh. So she been throwing that dynasty sign.
And no.
No needing me trying to be lying.
I've been trying to be signed.
Trying to be a millionaire?
How I use two lifelines. How I use two lifelines?
But to be a millionaire popping? And he was in the same hospital where Biggie Smalls died.
The doc said he had blood clots.
But he ain't Jamaican, man.
Story on MTV.
But he ain't trying to make a band.
I swear shit like this.
History in the making.
Through
man.
The wire, man. Nah.
How can you not say that's one of his best songs?
Because We Don't Care was more inspirational.
You're right. We don't care.
It touched
Let's
the hood.
Go to the next song. You know what I mean?
That's crazy, bro.
No. What do y'all say? Colin, what do you say? Dallas, Raven, Dan, Color, what y'all got?
People say Jesus Walks.
I went to Jesus Walks and they turned me down. Listen to this, y'all. I played them Jesus Walks.
And that was out before. No, go ahead. What y'all got, Raven? Come on. You said you had. Don't go look now. You said you had it already.
Raven,
I know what you're doing.
Raven for the say some get, randomness.
And y'all can think.
Welcome to the good life.
I got like it. Sometimes.
I got it.
Greg, what's your guess?
RoboCop.
To RoboCop is nuts. That's slow jam.
Slow jam. Yeah.
Come on, man,
Close.
Tell us.
It was just drive slow.
I knew it. I felt it.
I need
to follow up. Hey, but you know, Drive Slow is an amazing album. I was too excited to
drive
see Pow Wow.
Drive Slow is Pow Wow's best verse on the song ever.
So I'm going to go top three outside of singles. So, like, B-Cuts. I'm going to go... Oh, well, fuck it then. You know?
Nah, like the song, we don't care.
Oh, no, I'm going to go.
Oh, somebody sensitive today.
Crazy, bro.
I'm going to go Spaceships, mm-hmm. I Wonder, and Champion.
Champion for sure. Yeah. Champion's good. I don't know if I can
be in the worst. What about Roses? Though. Roses don't make nobody top.
Roses, but it's so deep. Like,
yeah.
I like deep.
I like Jovial kind of.
Nah, for sure. That's why I got Roses around my grandmama picture right now, actually.
No, I like
deep Kanye.
Kanye.
Cause he says it's deep. That was crazy though.
That's a good one. What was the three again?
Spaceship,
yeah.
I Wonder, and Champion.
Yeah, I Wonder. I definitely wouldn't put that in nothing. It's a cool song.
Hey Mama, though. That's like, a good one for me. Like, I like
good
Hey
production
Mama.
And then like flow on that one. Like, I fuck what I want.
Okay. That's what say you?
Well, I was going to go with The Wire, but since you already got it.
You can backdoor it, Pause.
I would, but I'd say also Can't Tell Me Nothing. Just because of what it... How it sits with
nah,
me.
Nah, for sure. Yeah, you talk about some inspirational stuff. Yeah.
Well, yeah, that for the first time.
Man,
on the
throw in inspiration, right. Then you got to throw in Everything I Am.
Oh, Everything I'm Not, maybe Everything I Am. Because Coming Past on the beat, he made it to a jam. All right,
since we here, we talking about Kanye. We on a tangent. We just killing time at this point.
Oh, well, forget the rest of the topic.
What's your favorite Kanye line? Nah, we going to get there. Just another tangent. What's your favorite Kanye line from a song?
Ooh, favorite Kanye line? Dang, that's tough.
Oh, I got mine.
What?
I'm the abomination of Obama's nation.
Okay. I wouldn't have went there, but I feel you. I'm an abomination of Obama nation.
Yeah.
That's a pretty bad way to start a conversation. All right, I'll give you one.
Damn, that's tough.
There'll always be haters. That's the way it is. Hating kids.
Dang, that's a good one. See, man, that's tough. I can't. It's no way I can say
it. It's not really a line. It's like if you give, you gotta give like a whole
some bars. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
But even like kind of got roses stuck in my head, like
your Magic Johnson had a kid, but hey,
you telling me if my grandmama in the NBA right now, she'll be okay.
But since she was just a secretary working for the church for 35 years, things supposed to stop right here.
My grandfather trying to pull it together. He's strong. That's where I get my confidence from. That part right there, ask the nurse, did you do the research?
She asked me, could you sign some t-shirts?
B-word, is you smoking reefer?
You don't see that we hurt, but still.
Nah, like, nah. Hey, man.
Kyle, what you got?
I miss the old Kanye. Straight out the go, Kanye.
Oh, my God. Is that a black card? I listen to her and I reply right away.
But I prefer the term African-American Express. Yeah. Mayonnaise color beans, yep. I put Miracle Whip.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Even if you're in a Benz, you're still in a coupe.
Yeah, for sure.
What was the topic again? What was we talking about?
Can't tell me nothing.
Now, what's all right, so White Me Now is not better than any Kanye song.
Right.
Now that we revisit it. But make a poll out of that.
It's all blue.
Nah, for sure.
Yeah. I ain't gonna lie, but I'm never getting in the car and be like, hey, listen to that Wipe Me Down right quick. That's just one of them songs, I guess.
But you're not gonna turn it off. But then
again, you heard so much.
Yeah.
In the clubs, everywhere, bars, like you just.
I don't know. If I'm just on a drive home at nighttime, I'm definitely turning Wipe Me Down off.
Yeah, I'm changing.
Damn, for real?
Yeah. Just chilling on the way home? Yeah, I don't wanna hear no Wipe Me Down.
I can't turn Wipe Me Down off, bro.
12 o'clock at night, you wanna hear B-O-O-S-I-E?
I'm not saying I'm purposely putting it on, but it's like I got my shit on shuffle and it come on.
I'm skipping it.
You getting out the car throwing
that
your hat
in bro. Hey, I got a tangent for y'all since we on tangents. Raven sent me a picture on social media. You got that picture? And it was a picture, an old picture of a bald head R. Kelly and Diddy at a party.
So, oh, what a party that was.
And little dude I posted said, what y'all think happened this night?
Is that Bill Cosby in the back?
Nah, I'm just playing. Yeah, I thought that was funny.
Surprise, surprise. That wasn't a party. That was a freak off.
Surprise, surprise. Damn. Nah, that's wild.
Oh, man. That's a freaky picture. That's crazy.
There was somebody in the comment that said, finally someone I can relate to.
That's crazy.
Bro, speaking of R. Kelly, you see, Diddy, you see they was getting on Meek Mill because he posted his truck for sale on Instagram.
What?
Yeah, they say, man, Diddy got that boy selling his trucks, man. I was like, dang, that's tough. You do got so much money, though. Like, he definitely shouldn't have posted his truck for sale on Instagram.
I don't know, because that was an issue, too, this week with Young Miami.
What happened?
Her Young Miami's closet.
Carisha's closet.
Yeah, Carisha's closet, and everybody was saying, hey, she must be going broke. She must be having a hard time. But, she wasn't the first person to do it. I don't know if that means, like, you going through some tough times because you selling something on social media.
Especially a celebrity who probably got way too much stuff to
begin. Well, she said she's been at, like, Carisha's closet, but they just resurfaced it.
And we've seen this with Fat Joe, Kim Kardashian, Gucci Mane, and Keisha Kayla.
But at that time,
Warren Sapp.
Warren Sapp was definitely in financial trouble. Definitely in financial trouble.
So do you think that mean they going through some financial issues?
It could be Warren Sapp was in trouble when Gucci them did it. That's when he first got out of jail?
That was a little bit after he got out.
But Warren had true flights on the web trying to get rid of them jumps.
Yeah, but nah, in a case like Meek Mill, I just think it's other ways.
Dame Dash?
Sell a truck.
Dame
Dash was in trouble at one point, too.
I mean, but I get it because you're kind of like using your celebrity to move it. So, like, if you had fans that really mess with you, they'd be like, I want a piece of their clothing.
And if you a celebrity, bro, you buy something new probably daily.
Right.
Yeah.
I think you might have to pass that out to your stylist or something and let them run that situation.
That's the thing, though. If it's not associated with your name, are you going to sell it that easy if it is associated with your name? Probably an easy six figures.
We went to Urban Necessities, and like on the bottom of the tag, it had the price, and then it said, out of Fat Joe's personal, Mayor or Fat Joe's personal selection. Right. Yeah,
that's true.
I don't know, man. It's just like you kind of mentioned Michael Jordan. Boys get them three-piece and sell them rings when times get hard.
O.J. Simpson style. Greg's Closet coming soon on Instagram. Y'all follow that page right now. It's active Greg's Closet.
I ain't
Closet.
Going through no hard time. I ain't going to put that on my life.
You just using your celebrity to sell some of your shoes?
Man, nah.
Louis Trainers.
Like, man, you know, speaking of three-peats, I don't think anybody had a greater three-peat than a girl that just had a Trayvon Diggs baby. I don't.
That's an amazing three-peat. That's a Michael Jordan run. 96, 97, 98. Joy
Chavis.
Man, so if y'all don't know about this girl, I just found out about her this week. Just because, as everyone knows, I'm a Dallas Cowboys fan. And Trayvon Diggs is having a baby by her. But this is her third child. And her first two kids, she has one with Bow Wow and mm-hmm. one with Future.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Dating pool is rough out there.
Yeah.
She's set too.
Yeah, all her kids gonna have good birthday parties. They probably battling who gonna have the best. Who you think gonna have the best birthday party?
Man, that's crazy. Yeah, she did what she was supposed to do. If you gonna have three baby daddies, then that's not a bad three.
That's tough right there. I don't understand how that works though. Like that, say the dating pool, is it that bad when you a celebrity? Like you gotta keep the same women in
rotation. It seems like that's like normal though. Man,
so they were talking about that on Nightcap with Unkin Ocho, where basically like once you hit a certain lifestyle, you're not really trying to go back to like a regular 9-to-5 type guy, or you know what I'm saying. So like it's celebrities, you know what I'm saying, and they tend to run in same circles and date the same women and date the same guys and stuff like that.
I wouldn't want one of them, none of them.
Yeah, though. I wouldn't.
Nah, at all. That's,
but at least they used to your lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to worry about nobody being a gold digger or anything like that. Like,
but they are.
Are you not worried about it with somebody who got two other babies with
of a
two other celebrities?
And other things are not an option. Like, I would assume that you digging for gold.
Yeah, it definitely.
Like, I feel like what's even more scandalous is Dre and Michelle, like, Jalen Green was talking to somebody
a little more.
it's Dre and Michelle. Like Jalen Green was basically talking to somebody. His last girlfriend was like somebody she considered a niece. And now like,
and he the same age as her son too.
Yeah,
I think that's nasty work, bro. Like I think that's like,
I don't care how
predatory
like,
and
I don't care how kawinky dink that is. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's just.
She was a high school graduate or a senior when he was born. Her son is his age.
That's tough.
So, awkward dinner. Do y'all think
it's... Yes. No. Yeah. I didn't hear what you said, though, so it doesn't matter.
I do, but then, I mean, you look at like Al Pacino.
Yeah, no, I definitely think it's the same. Like, I'm not at 34. I'm not about to date an 18-year-old, bro. That's weird. Like,
yeah, that is pretty weird.
I was probably a junior when she was born. I would change her diapers if it was my cousin or something. Like,
so who do you think is more? Who do you think is more at fault? Al Pacino being 83 years old, or the 30-year-old that had a baby by him?
30-year-old is she was fishing.
Yeah, at 83, you just trying to get it out, fam. Whatever it is. Whatever it is at 83, you just trying to get it out. Ain't nobody blaming 83-year-old Al Pacino for nothing.
Like, either way, both ways, it's nasty work, bro.
Yeah, for sure. So, social media sneaker personality Professor Skoola had an interesting top on the tape on an interesting take on a topic around here that we've been talking about for a while. Colin, can you read what sparked this conversation?
Yeah, so he received a tweet. And it said, you can't call yourself a sneakerhead if you don't have Black Cement 3s or Bread 1s, Black Toe 1s, Red Toe 1s, Black Metallic 5s, Taxis. I can go on and on. LOL.
What about all the other shoes that came out before or in between all of those? What you think about that, man? I know, and that's somebody who's like a Nike purist just as much as a Jumpman purist. I know, like, saying you have to have those to be a sneakerhead or be considered a sneakerhead is kind of crazy.
I feel like, I mean, you know, we talked about this on the Heathcliff podcast, but...
You mispronounced Denise.
Okay. But I feel like novice sneakerheads always, like, try to say some ignorant shit to, like, prove how knowledgeable they are. And it's just one of those instances, bro, where it's like, of course that doesn't make sense. Like, you know, as somebody who's been doing it for almost 20 years now, like, I gravitate to the people who have, like, obscene collections. You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's it, as we all do.
Right, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I think it's Air Forces.
Right, which it's crazy not to even mention Air Forces, and it came out, what, 3 years before the Jordan 1 ever was thought of.
Somebody that come to mind from the Nike Talk days, Seven Heaven. His shit was Retro 7. Right. You know what I'm saying? So, it's like, that's the stuff, like, I appreciate because, like, it's not on the beaten path. And I probably would agree more if, like, it was, like, more essential silhouettes, like an Air Force One, right, ensemble, a shell toe, or something like that. But, like, it doesn't matter, bro. Where would you like?
Oh, yeah. Then he named, like, four different Jordan 1s, though.
Right.
Jordan 1s, Metallic 5s, Taxi 12s, bro. It's so much other good stuff that came out in between all of those, bro. Like I said, the Air Force One and before the Jordan 1. Like, how can you not include the Dunk before the Jordan 1? How can you not include at least the Air Force One or a Dunk? And like, those are today's essentials still.
Right.
What, 30-some years later?
Right.
40 years later, and you don't mention those? Like, who cares about a Jordan 1 or a Jordan 3? Like, I love them. Like, I definitely feel that coming. Like, I feel like I have to have a Bread 1, a Black Seaman 3. But I also feel like I need some Air Force 1s. I feel like I need some Air Max 1s or Air Max 180s or...
kind of like music. Like,
some...
I might listen to Boosie.
Diamond Terse or some Griffies, bro. Like, yeah. Some Barclays. It was a lot of eras in between there that ran parallel with Jordan, bro. Like, I think that's insane to say.
What you saying, Ray?
If y'all could put it into words, what would y'all consider a sneakerhead to be then? I feel like it's a very term that's used loosely at this point.
I wouldn't. Yeah. Like, that was something that came out to us. I don't know. Right. I like shoes.
It's funny because just before you said that, I was finna say, but are any of us, and I say us, I mean like our age group, are we calling ourselves sneakerheads?
Nah, like, we just like shoes.
I don't
shoes.
Think
you
nobody
like what
going
you like,
and say, like, you know what? I'm a sneakerhead.
Yeah, that's kind of corny.
I think that's a red flag that you not into sneakers if you calling yourself a sneakerhead. You know,
if you our age or old and you calling yourself a sneakerhead, it lets us know when you started doing this.
Yeah.
Like, you ain't really true to this.
But, I mean, shout out my sneakerheads. Though. Y'all come shop with us. We'll be in San Antonio soon. Y'all pull up on us, kicking.com. But, I mean, to each his own. But, I mean, a sneakerhead is just somebody, I think it's supposed to mean somebody who loves shoes and is a part of the culture. But we just, that's how we say it. Like, we like shoes. Like, you know, we into
it.
The
simple.
You know, we into the sneaker culture. Like, and we talked about this a while ago. Like, Jason Maiden said, that actually made me stop using the term sneakerhead for sure. When he was saying, you know, it's derived from a crackhead. Like, being a fiend for anything is not a good thing. So, I don't know. I
essentially don't think there's a such thing as a sneakerhead because if you come from that derivative, it's just like, none of us buying every single thing that come out. We don't have to have. I guess it is some people who will skip a bill for. I have skipped a bill for it back in my college days.
Sure, yeah.
I told my mom my lights was about to get turned off and I bought some Jordans, but you know. But I don't believe in the time. I don't think that's the time. But back to the topic, like, what do you think?
Oh, I think he was totally wrong anyway. I mean, so let's just say we agree with the term sneakerhead. I would consider myself one if we agree with that term of what it is. Like, but let's just say, a sneakerhead, somebody likes shoes. I don't have any of those Jordan 1s.
I can't care less.
And I could probably tell whoever made that comment more about those Jordan 1s than he can.
Yeah.
So I don't agree with that
at all. Whoever said it probably never seen Jordan play. Probably don't know what he looked like.
Right.
On a doctorate level, if we had to flip it, what is one silhouette you would recommend for a novice or somebody who just started?
I know the answer to that.
Yeah, no, I mean,
Air Force.
Yeah, like, I mean.
Yeah.
What like, you know, when we have customers in here, I say, like, are you looking for something, like, day-to-day or an outfit shoe? If it's day-to-day, all white Air Forces, Panda Dunks.
Now I feel like I'm contradicting outfit myself. Shoe? But
all
I would,
whites.
I would say, like, a white C-Man, black C-Man 3 just because, like, I feel like it's you could dress it up or you can
if
dress it down.
If they're available for sure. Yeah, like if that was on the shelf, like, for sure. But anything like white, black, gray,
right?
If that's your shoe and you're going to wear it on a daily basis. Yeah. Now, if you got more bread to, you know, you want to drop 4 or 5 pairs, then we can get into different colors. And
but I feel like the options. Air Force One is like so influential, bro. Like, it's like the most influential shoe after the Panda Dunk.
It is the Ralph Lauren of the sneaker world, bro.
What is the Panda Dunk? The Louis Vuitton of the sneaker world then?
More like
bro, y'all crazy. I want to have this argument.
No, more like the Tommy Hill figure.
The Panda Dunk is the most. It's getting there. The Panda Dunk is the most influential sneaker ever.
Ever?
Yes.
Nah, I don't agree with that.
Bro, this is the most sought after shoe in the last 30 years, bro.
What? They wrong too. Before 3 years ago, nobody even cared about the Panda Dunk.
Before 3 years, I'm talking about now.
No,
today.
But you said ever.
Like ever. I think like it's like white Air Force Ones. Like everybody looking for Panda Dunks. Like you got moms, grandmas, dads, brothers, sisters, cousins, bro. Everybody, if they want a Panda, like everybody at some point wanted a Panda Dunk.
Well, I tell
you
what.
My mama wanted a Panda Dunk.
But you say it's the most influential shoe ever?
That's how I feel.
Matt Malti wrote an article on Complex that said in the last 5 years, it's the most iconic silhouette.
Last 5 years, I
that's the wrong
no, because even pre-pandemic, wasn't nobody looking for no Panda Dunks.
Yeah,
it came out 2020.
Well, I tell you what, when the Panda Dunk gets to 20 years, like the all-white Air Force One, then we can talk.
But at the moment, though, like
no, it's
not a person that didn't want a pair of Panda Dunks. Like, look how much people were paying for Panda Dallas. You know how much were people paying for Pandas at the beginning of the Panda hype? Like, bro, that shit was going for like between $300 and $500 at some point. Like, you could use a few pair of Panda Dunks to get any shoe you wanted. Like, I was going to Nike and getting every pair of every time Panda Dunks hit, I was buying them.
Shooting
I'm
fish
trading
in the barrel.
Panda Dunks 2 or 3 pairs for Travis Scott's. Like I can't trade 2 or 3 pair of white Air Force Ones for nothing. So, that's like my, like, I just think it's like a crazy influential shoe. Like, I never seen him with my own eyes besides, like, a Jordan. A shoe that, like, everybody, no matter the age, like, people wanted or was looking for it. Like, I don't feel like that about white Air Force Ones. Like, I never felt like somebody, dad, grandma, I mean, depending on what culture you come from. But this reigns all cultures, races, genders. Like, it was everybody. I don't feel like that about, I mean, white Air Force Ones did just have a run, the dirty ones. But, you know, like.
I just feel like it's like either you want slow and steady or you want, like.
I'm just talking about now.
Like it's
an amazing run.
The Panda
just think about it. Like every NFL game that we watched, whole coaching staff got on Pandas. Like I don't see no other shoe that's like that.
But I think you see that because Nike has finally found a way to match the demand for the supply for the demand.
The demand means a lot. That's what I'm saying. The demand is way more than I think any other shoe in a long time.
But I'm saying like you're not able to do like 3 Pandas for Travis Scott's now. Like, because the supply and the demand has caught up. Just like Icy White.
But the demand is still there.
Oh, yeah. Anytime we get Pandas, they selling out. Like, I give it 2 weeks, and, like, that batch will be gone.
I see people today posting Pandas, and I'm like.
As opposed to 3 years ago, people was literally pulling up in front of the store, hitting their heads of lights, and running in like, I need nothing to have.
But at the same time, our whites had to run like that since we've been here, Castle, too.
Now.
We were selling 100 pair of all whites in a month.
And, bro, if you want to go back to when we was in high school, like,
but,
if you're talking
it,
about.
But it wasn't a 4-year run. We on year 4 with Pandas.
But if you're talking about, like, D-Boys is buying 6 packs of all whites. You know what I'm saying?
Think they
like,
still, I think they do more than that now. I think it's still a thing, but I just think, like.
1 wear, 2 wears.
You naming a specific group of people. I'm saying you had grandmas and you had all ages, races, sexes, everything looking for Panda Dunks.
And if we really want to talk about it, the Samba, it won't ever get as high as that, but like wearability and demand, the Samba is getting there too.
I've seen people run to a pair of Panda Dunks on the wall like it was a Travis Scott just sitting there.
Yeah.
Like excited to get it.
So I think when we look back around the pandemic, what we're going to probably remember about all of it is the wearability and the culture hype of the Panda. I think there's a lot of unique circumstances, one being a pandemic. To be in some pandemic money. I think, honestly, you could say, in my opinion, The Last Dance influenced all of the craze just as much as anything else.
The Last Dance? Oh,
because everybody was sitting at home and got rehyped on retros and then got a pocket full of money. And then
it was kind of like everything that made sense, and everything skyrocketed. So I think we can say that, but I think there's a lot of conditions around that that are unique to just the normal sneaker culture conditions. I think it's an exception to the rule, basically.
Right.
Well,
I can't agree. How do we even get here?
I don't know, but Dan told us we need to get out of here, and we went somewhere totally different. But since we need to move on to the next topic, I think I know what my bring 'em back is. Panda Dunks. Bring them back again. Oh, shit. Every time they hear you kicking it, they do great. Bring back the Panda Dunk.
Yeah,
that's not my real bring them back. Skip that and they gotta go around. Come back.
Oh, we got some pandas right now.
Go ahead, y'all. I'm gonna come back.
Well, this is bring them back, where we talk about a shoe that hasn't been retro recently or ever that we would like to see brought back. If you put it on a keyboard or write it down, it'll be B-A-C-K, apostrophe E-M, with 3 exclamation marks. So bring them back. Colin, what's your bring them back?
So, as we know, this summer, NCAA football will come back for the first time.
What is the name? Since NCAA football came out. At least 10, right?
At least 10 years. So, in the past, Nike has collaborated with EA Sports or Madden. And,
actually, I think it's been like 9. I think last one was 15, wasn't it?
15, okay. So, yeah, like, almost 10 years. I would love to see a NCAA football Nike collaboration to commemorate this joyous occasion.
What was your favorite one?
Ooh. They only did one for NCAA, didn't they? That one with Tim Tebow, that Florida color one. The same year they did the trainer.
And yeah, that's why they're doing the Hirachi trainer.
They did that Drew Brees one. Yeah. That was like the football 11.
I think that was my favorite one when Drew Brees made the cover. And it was like a brown, chocolate brown football leather on
that.
That
was for Madden, though.
Yeah. It's all EA. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Okay, yeah. But I would like to specifically see an NCAA.
Yeah, like the
on
Tebow.
On a NSW silhouette. Air Force, Dunk, whatever. But bring them back.
Yep. My bring them back happens to be right here. Just because I did it for Air Force Friday.
Oh, he cheated.
The Busy P Air Force One. I need these brought back because these tapped at them, you know what I'm saying? My midsole got soft, I can't even wear them.
Damn,
so yeah, they done.
Damn.
So I need these brought back.
Maybe the Busy G?
The Busy G.
Solely released, they're kicking it?
You know it.
All right, that leaves me, huh? My bring them back. I need your help for this one. It was that Air Max, remember we talked about it? It had the cover, the front part was covered and it had the lines.
Oh,
what
the
was
Turmoil.
Nike Air Max Turmoil, I hope.
That's what it is. Yeah.
Then we'll provide you with a picture for it, but I never was able to get them. But it was one of those East Bay looks that I never was able to get. And I say bring, it's time to start bringing some of that old Air Max stuff back that just don't get no love today.
You know, I'm actually looking up the Turmoil. But you know, that's actually, not the Turmoil. Damn, I can't even think of the name. Me and Cam talk about that shoe all the time. But we'll edit and put an asterisk of the name of it right now.
There we go. It's hard to remember old stuff that have never been brought back. So it's time to bring them back. We're going to provide you with the right name.
Right. And yeah, the Turmoil is a turf shoe. That's my brother Jacob's favorite shoe.
Turmoil had like 1-6 or something, though. Maybe it was something like that.
Was that an interchangeable shroud?
It had a strap on it, though. Turbulence.
Turbulence with the strap slip on.
The Air Max Turbulence is what he's talking about. But right on cue, though, because since they bringing back the...
I thought it would have followed the Prestos or something like that, but...
But they're bringing back the... what's my shoe I've been wanting to come back forever? With the dice on it. The dice looking... crap. The shoe that coming back.
Sunder,
oh. Yeah. Since they bringing back the Air Max Sunder, I think the Air Max Turbulence would be a good follow-up to that shoe. Yeah, they did have a bunch of different turbulences.
A bunch. It was a lot of them.
But that would be a good follow-up. Yeah, and that's bring them back.
Well, that was some good bringing back, guys.
This one right here.
A little different right there. Yes, 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 yes. The little different. I want y'all to see that. Hey, take a picture. Take
I'm going to send it to Dan.
But, you know, this brings us to my favorite segment, To Be or Not To Be, Greg's segment.
Yes, sir. So, To Be or Not To Be, in my free time, I like to watch Tubi movies. So on To Be or Not To Be, I take a look at a Tubi movie and I grade it on 1 through 5 using Kool-Aid cups. 1 being the least amount you can get, 5 being the highest. I grade 5 different categories, those categories being digital quality, audio quality, soundtrack, the acting, and the plot. So this week, we take a look at the movie M.O.E.T. It's an acronym for Money Over Everything. So I know me and Colin thought it was kind of funny how they used this acronym Money Over Everything, and they made the E and the T two different letters.
And it's one word.
And it's one word. Kind of like if somebody had like upper echelon and called it like UPE. But yeah, but shout out to you know, shout out to everybody in upper echelon.
Shout out to my boy Dix, man.
But yeah, nah, so this
that's
movie,
crazy, bro.
So this movie, my way, features your girl Mina Monroe.
My boo.
Yeah, so this movie is new to Tubi. It's been on Amazon Prime for a while, but it just got on Tubi. So the digital quality is pretty solid. Like anything Mina Monroe is, I feel like they have a pretty solid budget. It also got our boy Ro Spit, kicking it Social Hour podcast alumni. Ro Spit, he's like Sweet. One of the first people that you see in the movie. Unfortunately, he dies pretty early in the movie as well.
That's terrible.
It is. But shout out to Ro, man. But the digital quality is pretty solid. I'm gonna get at a 4, Raven, on that digital quality scale, a good old 4. The audio quality was solid as well. It's sometimes they be in the club, it's kind of low, can't really hear exactly what they saying, but it's to be expected. I'm gonna get at a 4 as well. The soundtrack was pretty solid. I really paid attention to the music this time. It seemed to fit with what was going on in the movie. A lot of the scenes in the movie take place at the strip club, so it had good strip club music vibes, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna get at a good
wipe
old,
me down.
Yeah, wipe me down. I'm gonna get at a 3.8, you know what I'm saying? The acting, it was solid, ain't gonna lie. Definitely had some people who did their things a little better than others, but it was good. So for the acting, let me get at I get at a 3.75. The plot, it seemed kind of predictable. Definitely know what scene, what's gonna happen. Had a few twists and turns in it, but the plot overall, I give it a 3.5. Just because I feel like we kind of seen that story a few times. But total that up and average it, and that is a 3.81. I'll go ahead and bump that up to a 3.85 for the movie, M.O.E.T. So if you're at home or got your phone, get on the Tubi app and check out M.O.E.T. M-O-E-T. Get them actors and the directors some views, run it up so they can get that money. You know, we've had such a wonderful time, a bunch of freestyles today. A bunch of random. It's never too many freestyles.
What then?
No. You know, we've come to my favorite segment of the show, which is Kenan Solo segment, also referred to as Tender Love and Care.
You think I blinked a lot this episode?
Chicken.
All right, guys, what's going on? We missed a week. We back. Couldn't wait to get back. Couldn't wait to eat some tenders. I've been enjoying all kind of tenders over the last week, and I hadn't even been able to tell y'all about them. Come on, Raven. Today's tenders come from Louisiana Crab Shack.
Thank you.
Louisiana Crab Shack, man. I don't know what I was trying to say, but I didn't even get to get it out. Colin, I thought we were supposed to have 4.
Thank you, Raven.
I got 4. You got 4? I only got 3. You got like 3 of the same ones. Anyway, Louisiana Crab Shack. So from Louisiana Crab Shack, we got a 4-piece chicken tender with fries, $13. We waiting on Colin to give us the dipping sauce and same one. And this is original. Oh, nope, I got original. Okay, I don't know. We just gonna eat some tenders. We just, whatever we got, we eat. So before we get the sauce grade, let's go ahead and get into it. I think you got an original tender.
What do you grade on?
My boy, man. That's why I need you in my life, man. So I grade these tenders after we eat them on flavor, size, price, freshness, and crunchiness. You want a ranch? I know you do. I got you. And I think we should get to it.
Yes, sir.
So this, I believe, this is an original, which is that one. Yours look like lemon pepper, mine look like original. Like got a little seasoning on it. All right, let's call it.
Oh.
Caught it. Let's get to it. No sauce. All right.
Let's go to
the rest of mine look the same.
I think that's bottom of the bayou. Let's go to that one with. Good. I believe it's Cajun. I'm gonna hit it with the wrench. Somewhere it's a lemon pepper. They do have more flavors. We don't got them up here. Fries. All right, let's get to it. Still one more bite. All right, so like I said earlier, Louisiana Crab Shack, let's get to it. Flavor, we had, I believe, 3 different flavors. Cajun, bottom of the bayou, which is the flavor they use for the crab boils because it's a seafood restaurant. And
Regular,
OG. Flavors was good. I thought the bottom of the bayou on a chicken tender would be like overpowering, salty maybe, but it really wasn't. It was really good. The OG, I'm not gonna lie, the tenders did not need any seasoning. They were still good, and the Cajun was good as well. Flavor, you ready, Raven? Dang. 3.75 out of 5. Besides, battered fries, Cajun battered fries. Can't go wrong with a battered fry. Some of my favorite fries. So for my side, I'm gonna give it a 4.5 out of 5. And they were fresh and crispy. Price. The tenders are kind of little. When I read 4 tenders, I was kind of excited. You get 4 tenders, $13 with a side, it's not bad. But the tenders were kind of skimpy, on the skimpy side. So maybe bad luck, I don't know. Price, I'm gonna give it a 3 out of 5. Freshness, it was made to order. Even on the transport, it still came hot, still good. They had the ventilation holes in the package, which is very, very important. And the presentation was fine too. For freshness, we're gonna give it a 4.5 out of 5. Crunchiness, I ain't gonna lie, like these probably like the crunchiest tenders, even after transportation or transport and everything else. Like, crunchiness was perfect, battered perfectly. I'm gonna give it a 5 out of 5. And that brings us to a what? 4.15 out of 5 tenders. I'm gonna bump that to 4.25 out of 5. Louisiana Crab Shack is really, really good. Like, I really don't have any complaints at all, besides that the chicken was kind of skimpy, but maybe I just got a bad batch. Who knows? So 4.25 out of 5 tenders.
What you think, Jay?
They were cool. Honestly, some of it was kind of salty for me. I feel like the bottom of the bayou was the top of the cholesterol. But flavorful.
I like salt. I like salt. That's my tender love and care for today. If you ever on the north side of Austin, close to the domain where Kicking It is, go try Louisiana Crab Shack.
Fried chicken.
Yeah, so shout out to Louisiana Crab Shack, man. Mm-hmm. Just make sure, like Kenan said, if y'all eat there, y'all make sure y'all get your blood pressure checked afterwards. Don't eat a whole bunch of that bottom of the bayou sauce.
Tell them
man.
Lightly.
Light bayou
lightly
sauce.
Coated.
Drink some water with it, too. But yeah, so now that we got that out the way, it is time for our Kicking It in the Comments section, where Lil Ray Ray reads some comments from different posts or different videos that we had this week, and we talk about them. Sometimes it might be a statement, might be a question. But what we got this week, Raven?
First of all, glad to be back. Y'all hair looking good.
Thank you.
Shout out to Cookie, Mr. Jesse. I don't think I'm gonna ever get over my new theme song.
Gucci Mama.
All right, so I just have a. You done? You want to sing it? Okay. I just have a few comments from a couple weeks ago. Y'all asked who had the best theme song to a black sitcom. Chief Beef, shout out to Keezy, said Jamie Foxx has the best theme song of all time. Both of them. But he said both of them. B-O-F-F-U-M. Both. Yes. One of the homies from Houston said, not gonna lie, Good Times always gonna be in my top 5. But that second Wayne's Brother intro is fresh. I don't even remember the second one of the Wayne's
Break yourself off a little piece.
Let's get into it then. Nah, I'm just playing.
It was a few people just singing along to whatever theme song y'all was singing. I think it was the original Wayne's Bros. Somebody else said, all that with TLC, shoulder shrug. On TikTok, they said, The Cosby Show has so many.
They did have a lot. I feel like they changed up every year, every 2 years.
And then on YouTube, they said Stanford and Son is top 3 sitcoms and theme songs.
Crazy.
Malcolm and Eddie theme song was slept on, though.
Malcolm and Eddie theme song what?
Slept on.
Yeah. So Stanford and Son had a good theme song. I wouldn't know if I would say top 3 sitcoms of all time. That's kind of wild. So look, shout out Jacob, my brother. He had an idea, and we're going to implement this, little Ray Ray, you. So we're gonna do a March Madness style bracket of black sitcom theme songs. So we're gonna create a bracket. We're gonna post the bracket up. And on top of it, we're gonna do an NIT bracket. No,
and look at bracket.
So we're gonna create a bracket. We're gonna post the bracket, and then we're gonna do Instagram polls every day until we get down to the winner. So y'all be on the lookout for that. We'll have a winner by next week, and we'll let y'all know.
I'll see you at work tomorrow.
Bright and early. But yeah, man, shout out to y'all. Shout out to Ray Ray for the Kicking It in the Comments section.
That was it? All right.
All right, well.
I really like this song.
Well, guys, here we are. Yeah, okay.
They want that G.
Yeah. We wrapping
it up.
We gonna
give it to you, man. Come on, man. Stop talking rap.
Look. Giving you all I got, I ain't saving. This was episode 37, like Dion with the Ravens. Man, that bar went too hard. Keenan, He was sipping on the bar. I'm lying, he was just sipping on a little bit of Crown. It's the end of the show, so you know it's going down. Like the end of the show when you look at the credits. Man, I had to go get it and come back.
I was
back.
Not sipping on Crown, I was sipping on the water. Top five, I'm a point guard, I'm a starter. You was going hard, but I'ma have to go harder. I don't know what else around. I was just ready
hanging
to go.
With Mr. Cooper had I'm a theme sleeping. Song. It was in vogue and they were singing that long. I don't know.
Wait. Time's up. Mr. Cooper had a theme song by in vogue, really?
Cooper. Hanging with my man. He's also
I don't remember that one.
Damn, play Miss Hanging with Mr. Cooper. Yeah, I thought this was over.
Another hour.
Who's my theme music?
They was in the video. Somebody else said, what somebody else said? How do I remember this? Sam for the Sun. Let me hear Sam for the Sun since we're here. That's what I thought.
That made me think about Malcolm and Eddie. And hey, y'all remember all the first episode?
This one was like,
oh, he was making up the words to the song. Y'all remember that?
That's what everyone sees.
He was like, Fred Sanford. Fred Sanford had a son named Lamont. Eddie Griffin funny, man. But yeah.
Malcolm and Eddie have a theme song?
Yeah, we played it last.
Did we?
Yeah, you can let that ride out. So appreciate y'all, though, if y'all made it this far. Appreciate y'all for making it and listening or fast-forwarding it past all the freestyles and all the randomness that we bring y'all every week, man. It's definitely appreciated. All three of y'all. We appreciate y'all.
All three of y'all.
Say
it no more.
Nah, but, man, we appreciate y'all for real. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe to our Facebook and our YouTube page. Make sure y'all follow us on all social media platforms. Tell your friends, tell your family, tell your enemies about the podcast, man. It's available on all streaming platforms. Be it on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, Instagram, Facebook, Threads, Twitter, aka X, Pinterest, and y'all know how Keenan get down on his OnlyFans page. But until next week, oh hey, I also got a shout out for Off the Bench, you know what I'm saying, for my 101 hoodie, y'all know what I'm saying.
Wish we all can get stuff.
Jealous. Man, I'm watching Friday. No. but yeah, appreciate y'all. Be on the lookout for our bracket of black sitcom theme songs. Yeah. And until next week, hit nah.
See,
I forgot. Dang, y'all continue to spread light and be the light of the world. You know what I'm saying? God bless y'all. Until next time, you know, I got to end on that positivity.
Yeah,
because
if it is to be.
It is up to G. I mean, me. Y'all go on YouTube, Amazon Music, Apple Music, check me out, Teddy G, Bun G, Pimp G, Pleasure G. Yeah, I appreciate y'all.
I like to have fun. And listen, this is the big one. Things on.